philosophical conversation. What can you do about the plant?
So I've been hanging it there. I can't just take it down.
Agreed. So what can you do?
Well, so you spoke with somebody last night, you said?
Nielsen.
Yep. I don't know, like, honestly, I don't know the procedure, man. Like, I don't
take
it down. I didn't hang it up there.
That was mud from last night.
I mean, it is, like, I get what you're saying. I got the code up here.
You're breaking the law.
I mean,
excuse me, bro.
Yes, sir.
I know you.
Mr.
Magnificent.
So, yeah, I had a letter earlier concerning their flag. Talked to a Mr.
Cox, you spoke with me.
Yes. Oh. And you said that their flag was not here no more.
I wasn't aware of it.
Okay. Were you up here when you talked to us? Or
you guys got cell phones?
Huh?
You guys got cell phones?
No. You called on that phone when I spoke with you. I said, you guys, there was a flag outside. I said, what?
No, on the wall behind you. Yeah.
Well, that's...
Okay. I just want to make sure that...
It's there, you know.
Right. And I can understand where you're coming from. You know, it's a flag we have posted for our fallen officers. Yeah. But where we're coming from, too, as a desecration, you know, we consider it... Across the nation, the thin blue line. It's basically, you guys are gang with it. I mean, no offense. I mean, I'm not trying to sound like a jerk, but I mean, it's like a gang with it. I mean,
absolutely.
No, this is just news to me, man. I didn't know that flag would upset anybody.
It's upset a lot of people.
It's meant to honor dead, severely injured policemen, and it's hanging next to a wall.
Right.
Full of murdered policemen, you know what I mean? So.
But you gotta look online and see the opposite as a civilian. I know you have ranking, right? So I know this.
So you see the good in it. Like we were saying, just take a glance online. Take a glance and see about that flag.
What did I find? What's
a lot of misconduct.
Look on YouTube.
Do you know what I mean?
Just look on YouTube.
It's compared. Their flag, they compare it to Blue ISIS. ISIS from the Middle East. Because you know why? Because of the lawlessness that's going on here. See, you know,
really?
We're gonna look into it, though.
Yeah, because see, the thing is,
it's kind of a stretch, though. Can we be honest?
No.
Really?
I mean, it's.
You know what, bro?
When I said, "Hey, listen,"
unless that, like a stretch to me. I know. That's why I said, look on YouTube, and you'll see the thousands of videos about that flag.
Domestic terror isn't to the fullest because why? Because when you look at all those videos, all they do is kill, steal, and destroy. Now, there's good apples. Don't get me wrong. Human beings in any system, but the whole system's corrupted, and that's it. When everybody pulls that flag out there, they're like, "What? We've been occupied. We've been occupied by a foreign entity."
Like, put it out where? Like, how? Like, what do you mean?
The first line of an occupied
because
force.
You guys, I'm sorry, go ahead, Joe. Go ahead.
Yeah. Who am I talking to? Okay, you, sir.
First line of an occupying force. They refuse to obey the same laws they enforce. The first rule of your policy is, because somebody's smart and they know that, we will obey all laws. That's the first rule of your policy. Okay? Mm-hmm. So, when you're breaking the law here, when you see a cop...
Yeah, I've been breaking it down because I got my editing program.
That was turned in, so, or found out.
I hope they find these.
I hope they these do, too.
Let me show you an example of this lawlessness. This is something from downtown where people, you get your system, your guys,
okay, downtown parking, by the way.
They park every single where they don't get tickets, but other people, the private sector, the citizens that work hard, they get booted, they get tickets.
But what are they responding? Yeah, they respond to a job though. I mean,
hey Ethan, how long is this? Right.
You gotta give.